people ask, where do you get your ideas? Well, right here. All this is my Martian landscape. Somewhere in this room is an African veldt. Just beyond, perhaps, is a small Illinois town where I grew up. And I'm surrounded on every side by my magician's toy shop. I'll never starve here. I just look around, find what I need, and begin. I'm Ray Bradbury, and this is... Well then, right now, what shall it be? Out of all this, what do I choose to make a story? I never know where the next one will take me. And the trip? Exactly one half exhilaration, exactly one half terror.
Crazy writer fella, aren't you? You looking for new ideas?
Yes. But what's that?
That's a dowsing rod.
Can you find water with it?
Give it a try.
What do I look for?
It's not so much what you look for, it's the feel. Feel. Touch it. That's it. Touch. Yeah. There's more than water down there. All kinds of things are hidden.
All kinds?
All kinds of things are buried there just under the grass.
Earthworms? Trapdoor spiders? Deathwatch beetles? 17-year locusts?
17-year locusts?
Wait a minute. Oh, no. It can't be.
Got an idea for a story?
Yes. Oh, yes.
Is almost ready. Now, I want you to run down to the store and get some ice cream for your father, all right?
I have to wait till the mummy comes.
Never mind about the mummies. Your father's going to be home soon. Oh, Heather, where do you pick up these things?
Thank you.
That voice on the phone. It sounded so familiar. Well, I can't waste time thinking about that now. Whoa!
Hey, you! Get out of here!
Sound inside the tube was especially eerie that night. All you could see was her hair blowing in the wind. The night was so dark, she was terrified.
Contralto or soprano?
Dad!
Her screams. Was sharp or flat?
Oh, Heather, look at this mess! Oh, Mom, I heard her screaming help! Help!
Heather!
That's what she said!
Come on, give me the magazine. Come on. Come on, let's go. Let's look at this. No, that's what she said.
Help, she cried. The mummy raised his cloth-wrapped hand. She screamed! Ah!
It's not a game, Daddy, damn it!
Heather!
I'm sorry, but you gotta believe me.
All right, I'll make a deal with you. You clean that plate and I'll walk over to the woods with you. Not so fast. There's time.
I didn't sleep a wink last night. Charlie Nesbitt and that wife of his screaming and yelling. Now, they're always fighting, those two. Funny, this morning they stopped.
Oh, I agree that Charlie's a little weird sometimes, but Mary Lou Ann's a very nice person. You should give yourself a chance to get to know her better.
I don't actually believe you went out with that woman.
Do you know she wrote me a song once?
Mary did?
Yeah, it wasn't bad either. See if I can remember it. La dee da 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 dee da. That's something else, isn't it? Well, you know what they say. It's not whether you remember the words, but how you sing the song. Let's go dishing that lost soprano.
Oh, Lord.
What about supper?
Oh, I'll put it in the oven.
This is it. This is the place.
Great. Well?
Listen.
You know,
Screaming woman! Maybe Maybe she's tired from screaming.
Maybe she's dead.
Don't say that. Pretty good. Get a shovel?
Get a spoon.
What?
Eat my ice cream.
Daddy!
That's my name.
Unless I hear screams. Let's hear it. Ow! Pretty good trick. Trick? You got one of those little cassette players under there. Yeah, and I'll lend it to you if you dig.
Whoa.
I'll give you the darn thing.
Okay.
Did you hear that, Dibby? She's wearing out. She's gonna die.
Oh, sure. Your batteries are just running down.
Dig!
Hey! What's going on here?
Mr. Kelly,
we were just...
Picking up my lot? This is my private property you're messing around with. You two shovel fast and hard and fill that hole back up.
We can't. We've got someone we've got to save.
Yeah.
Fill that hole back up. And if I ever catch you around her again, I'll call the cops.
What do you mean? He's lying. I mean, why would he be so angry? Why would he make us fill up the hole, huh? I bet you he killed Mrs. Kelly and buried her there.
Yeah, but that screaming lady's not real.
Dippy. I got an idea.
Let's go.
Say? Yeah, they were fighting all last night, but today, nothing. I betcha it's Charlie Nesbitt.
That's it. So long.
Dippy, come on! Forget it.
Is your wife, I mean, your wife home?
My wife, what do you want with her?
The other day, she told me to come get, a recipe.
For what?
For what? For peach. Yeah, peach. Peach pie.
Well, she's not here, right now, but she should be back any minute. Why don't you come in and wait for her? Have a seat. It's really nice to see you.
Did she go shopping?
Yeah, she had to get a few things.
Things?
For her hair.
Oh. I also wanted to tell her something else.
What?
About the screaming woman.
What screaming woman?
She's buried underground. And she's screaming. Except nobody believes me.
Why don't you give me a try?
Well, you're just like my dad, and he doesn't believe me either.
Where did you say this screaming woman was?
In Mr. Kelly's lot. Except I think she's gonna die.
Really?
Well, nobody's gonna help me. And her voice is getting weaker.
You certainly have a weird imagination. How about a cold drink? Say, Heather,
nobody believes me.
Thank you.
time for sleep. You've had a busy day.
I tried to help her. I really did.
I know you did, sweetheart. Happy dreams. Came back to me.
What did?
Oh, you know that song we were talking about earlier today?
Song? What song?
Well, the one that Mary Nesbitt wrote for me. Sure. Heather. Oh, my God.
Perhaps that tree is just a lie.
Heather, she's gonna be all right.
You know Tom Fortnum and his pal Joe Willis? Well, according to Mrs. Goodbody, they're growing mushrooms in their basement. They got these mushrooms from the mail about 2 weeks ago. And 4 days ago, Mr. Willis disappeared. They say he was in New Orleans on business. But according to Mrs. Goodbody, and I believe it, he's been captured by aliens. And those aliens come from the mushrooms in Tom Fortnum's basement. So, here's what we can do. First,